all the brand new features in Photoshop, Harmonize is the one that's got the most attention. We're going super in-depth in this video. And why do I have this Team Water shirt on? Well, keep watching and I'll tell you later on. As I said in my last video, we're going to look at the important features more in depth, one at a time. The first one we're going to start with here is Harmonize. Harmonize is definitely the hero of this release, and it can be found in Photoshop Beta right now. If you don't have the beta, just go to Creative Cloud, click on Beta, and you'll see the Photoshop Beta. You can download it there. And on most systems, you can run that alongside the regular shipping version, so you don't have to uninstall it. Let's see exactly how Harmonize works. So let's start with this image, and we're just going to remove the background. We're not worried about cutout quality, not the point of this video, but let's just choose Remove Background. And now we're going to use the Move tool and drag this up into the tab of the other image we want to add it to. And then I'm just going to release, and we can see there's our people. Let's resize them. So we're going to hit Control T, that's Command T on Mac for Free Transform. Notice it brings up the handles, and we can drag on those, any of those handles, to resize it and just reposition just by dragging around. Let's go a little bit smaller. They're probably still a little bit large, but this is going to show what I want to show you pretty well. So let's hit Enter to apply it. So if we look at the layer I brought in, notice that the lighting direction is different. See how the shadows are coming towards us, so it's front lit. And if we look at this, we can see it's kind of top and to the side. You can see where the shadows are going there. There's obviously no shadows in the bottom, so they look like they're just thrown in there. And even the color is a little bit different. So why don't we go ahead and we're going to choose the Harmonize button. And this is going to automatically make these match. All right, so when we look at this, we have three different variations that we can look at. So there's the first variation, the second, and the third variation. So if you'll notice, what they're all doing is they're changing the lighting to get it looking like it's coming from the right direction, and they're adding shadows and also changing the color to match. So I'm not sure which one you like best. Maybe we'll go with the first one just because of the shadows being a little bit better. Notice it didn't cut out the transparency in the glass. It can't do that. We'll look at that in a moment. This is using Firefly. So this is the same as using Generative Fill or Generative Expand, but what it's doing is it's using these as a reference image and reproducing them as accurately as it possibly can, and then, you know, relighting them to match the scene. So if we look at what's happening here, if I hide the background layer, you can see what it's done is it's generated the new people. Let me just show the old people here, and we can see there's the original, here's the new one. Let's hide the original for a second. So one of the things you might notice here is this is actually generating the entire layer. I can show you this by holding down the Shift key and clicking on the mask to hide the mask. So what it's doing is it's actually generating the entire image and just masking out the parts that have changed. The problem with that is resolution. It's limited to 1024 by 1024. So it stretches the pixels. And to demonstrate, let me just double click to go to 100%. If we look at these deck chairs, and then I turn the mask back on, turn on the background, there's the original background. Hold the Shift key, click. There's the generated. Notice the ocean has lost resolution. The chairs have lost resolution. The original at 100% generated. It's pixely. Look at the tree before, after. Now, if we look at the people, you might not notice it too much. So let's show the original people, and we're going to hide the layer. So if I change this layer now, notice the only thing changing is the people because everything else is masked. So if we look at the people, yeah, we're losing a little bit of resolution. Depending on the purpose you want to use this, this could be possible. Well, let's have a look at another option. When we click in here, you'll see there's a little upscale here. So if we click on here, what it will do is it will enhance the quality. Now it says this variation is too small to enhance. So that means that this area here is less than 1024 by 1024. So it's not going to be able to enhance it. If it was larger than that, then it would enhance it and make it look better. So if we look at this, what are we losing? Let's zoom in a little bit more. Let's go to 200%. And if we look at the detail in her hat, here is the original. And then this is what we added. Oh, we're definitely losing some detail. Part of that has to do with the lighting direction, but part of that also has to do with the resolution. Same with her hair. Look at the detail here in the skirt. Okay, so that's a little bit of a drawback. Let's have a look at the second drawback, and then we'll look at some solutions. So the second drawback of this is if we decide we want to move the people, notice that the whole shadow and everything is moving with them. So it's not really possible to have those shadows on a separate layer, like if you composited it yourself. This one is an easy fix. If you want to move the people, just turn that layer off, take the original, move them, and then hit harmonize and regenerate. Only takes a few seconds. All right, let's look at the second problem though, and that is the resolution. So here's a little trick that I have to get around that. So what we're going to do is, let's take the originals we're working on here. Let's grab the background. Now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to make a selection around here. We're giving it enough space to generate those shadows, of course, at the bottom. But what we're going to do is we're going to limit the amount of space that this is generating. I definitely want to give it enough of the background that it recognizes the lighting and it recognizes the color. So you don't want that too tight for what we're going to do here. And obviously you need the space to generate all the parts you need to generate. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to hit Control J. So if we hide this, we've just got this small section. So I'm going to take that, and I'm going to take the original with the people. So we've got these two layers. I'm going to right click and convert this to a smart object. Now we're going to open the smart object in a new document by simply double clicking on it. And now we open. So what we have now is we have these two layers just like before, except now these two layers are inside a smart object which thinks that this is a smaller document. At this point here, with this selected, just choose harmonize once again. And now that 1024 by 1024 is going to be constrained to the smallest space, which is going to give us more resolution to work with for our subject. All right, so let's look at the different variations. Maybe this variation here is good. So what we're going to do now is just Control S to save the smart object. Now when we close the smart object, it's going to update in our document. And then if we turn on the background, it's going to match perfectly because we just made a smart object from that selection. And now let's have a look at the quality compared to the quality that we did when we applied it to the entire image. So let's zoom in here. If we look at this at 100%, let's turn on when we applied it to the whole image. Look at that. Look how bad the shadows are here. If we turn that off, look, we've got these nice detailed shadows. Now we're looking at the detail in the hat has come back. The hair, the body, the skirt. Yeah, we've definitely got a better result there. So that's one way to get around that. Now, by the way, if you wanted to fix that glass, all you would need to do is just make a selection around it with the object selection. At this point here, we're going to create a mask. Hold down the Alt or the Option key. So we're going to inverse that mask. And now we've just cut out that area. And then with the mask density, turn it down a little bit. And now we can bring back some of that glass. Is it perfect? No, there's other ways of doing it, but that's certainly better than what it was. And when we zoom out, it looks fine. All right, let's move on to some other examples. So why don't we add this boat to the water? So we're going to remove the background. Just drag it into the layer and release. Let's make it a little smaller. Control Command T for free transform. maybe drop it in here somewhere, maybe a little smaller. All right, and just for the sake of making it look a little bit better, I'm going to grab the mask here and I'm going to grab a brush and make it look like it's in the water a little bit. Not going to spend a lot of time on this, so no, it's not going to be perfect, so no need to critique. So we're going to click here, and then we're going to hold the shift key, and so we're just going to kind of put this boat in the water a little bit. Obviously, yes, this could be done better and smoother, but this is good enough for what we're trying to do here. All right, so let's go ahead now, and we're going to hit harmonize. All right, and as you can see, we've got a nice reflection there. And one of the things to note about this reflection is if you look at a true reflection, it's not just taking something and flipping it upside down and masking it. Notice we're seeing the underside of the boat, which is the opposite side from what we're seeing here, which is more realistic because it's reflecting that. Here's a composite that I did. And if we look, Taylor Davis is our model here. And if I look at the photo, there's the original photo I took of her. And then I blended her into the background. So I've created a magic bow here, and we've got this light, and it's reflecting that blue light onto her leather and onto her violin. And then, of course, you know, the shadows I painted in. So if we look at this particular original here, don't even worry about the shadows. It's just look at the lighting when we're doing custom lighting like this, and let's try harmonize and see how well it does compared to my handwork. So this is harmonize, and this is my handwork. So as you can see, it's good at doing kind of a realistic representation, but when you've got stylization going on here, like we've got different coloring and stuff, and maybe I could apply the color grade afterwards, etc. But if you look at this, I painted these shadows in. If we look at it here, notice there's the original photo, and then look at where I painted in. You can see I painted in shadows here. I painted in highlights there. But then when we apply this, those don't appear. Another thing you might notice in this situation, when we go up to 100%, the loss in quality of resolution is clearly adamant. This is the original photograph. This is my composite. And this is harmonized. So as you can see, it doesn't have the resolution to work on a high-res image at this particular time. So when it comes to doing a natural representation, it's pretty good. When it comes to doing something stylized like this, where I didn't want it to look natural, the handwork still comes in there. So I would say, you know, a skilled retoucher's skills are not going to be replaced by this AI, but they're definitely going to be useful for doing quick mockups or for people that are less inexperienced to be able to do more believable looking composites than they could before. So why this shirt? I'm part of Team Water. It's the largest creator collaboration event ever in history. 1 in 10 people in the world lacks fresh, clean water. So what we're doing is we're raising $40 million to bring fresh water to millions of people. $1 can bring fresh water to one person for a year, $20 for decades. So if you want to know more, check out teamwater.org. And if you want to donate, or everything you need to know is right there. So thanks for watching. I hope you found this video useful. Drop a comment underneath and let me know what you think about it. Don't forget to go to teamwater.org where you can learn more about helping 2 million people get fresh water. And anyway, if you want to see the other video that I've done of all the new features in Photoshop, check it out. It's over here somewhere. If you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications. You won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.